Hello! In this video, I'm going to show you how to crochet this very cute little dog, Amigurumi. The dog that I'm holding is made from sport weight cotton yarn and a 2.5mm crochet hook. And the bigger dog is made from chenille, super bulky yarn and a 5.0mm crochet hook. The pattern is exactly the same, so you can use any yarn that you like to crochet this dog. In the video I'm going to use sport weight cotton yarn because then you can see the stitches better. But I will also be showing some tips in chenille yarn when it is needed. You can find the free written pattern of this dog on my website. The link is in the description of this video. And you can also find all the links to the materials that I'm going to use in the description. If you like making amigurumi, please subscribe to my channel and like this video, and comments are also very appreciated. I have many more amigurumi videos on my YouTube channel and also on my free patterns on my website. Like this very cute little bunny and all of the amigurumi that you can see right now and many, many more. And you can use any yarn that you like to make all of these very cute animals. Now we're going to start making the dog. We're going to start making the main body of the dog. We're going to start making a magic circle. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice. Then go into the two loops with your crochet hook. Wrap the yarn and pull it through both loops. Then you're gonna grab the yarn again and pull it to the loop on your crochet hook. That's how you make a two-looped magic circle. If you find it difficult or if you're using for example plush yarn, you can also use a one loop magic circle. I made a video about this. It's in the corner of this video right now. Now we're going to make 6 single crochets into this magic circle. So I'm going to go into the magic circle with my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn and I'm going to pull it to the magic circle. Now I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops. This is the first single crochet. Now I'm going to make the second single crochet. And then the third single crochet. And the fourth. The fifth. And one more, 6 single crochets. Now, made 6 single crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm going to close the magic circle. You pull the small piece of yarn, and one loop will become smaller. Don't close completely yet, but pull on the bottom side of that loop to close the other one completely. And then pull the small piece of yarn again to close the magic circle completely. Now we can start on the second round. A tip for if you want to use plush yarn, it's probably better to use a magic circle with one loop instead of two, like this. And I will also show you how to make it a bit easier to close the magic circle with plush yarn, because this can be a little bit difficult. So if you've made 6 single crochets, if you start pulling here, it might be a little bit difficult to close. So pull on different places on your stitches, so here and here, and then you will see it will become easier to close the magic circle. I'm going to start with round 2. First I'm going to take a little bit of leftover yarn and I'm going to place this before I start with the second round. And in the second round, we're going to do an increase in every stitch of the round. That means that we're going to single crochet 2 times in every stitch. So in this first stitch, I'm going to do 2 single crochets. This is the first single crochet. And then the second single crochet. And in the second stitch, also 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So this is the first single crochet. And then the second single crochet in the same stitch. And again, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And we'll be doing this in every stitch of the round. So in the end, we will have made 12 stitches. This is the last increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And then I'm going to start with round 3. First I'm going to move the marker yarn. And then I'm going to do 1 single crochet in every first stitch. And in every second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. First move the marker yarn and then go into that first stitch. And make 1 single crochet. Then I'm going to go into the second stitch. And I'm going to make an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So on the first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And repeat this until the end of the round. On the first stitch, 1 single crochet. And in every second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So in the end, we will have made 18 stitches. So this is the last increase of round 3, and now we're going to go to round 4. In round 4, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches, and in every third stitch, we're going to make an increase. So on this first stitch, 1 single crochet, and in the second stitch, 1 single crochet, and in the third stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Then you have to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. So in every first 2 stitches, 1 single crochet, and in every third stitch, an increase. This is the last increase of round 4. Now we're going to start with round 5. In round 5, we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches. And we're going to make an increase in the 4th stitch. So in this 3rd stitch also 1 single crochet. And then in the 4th stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And we're going to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. So in every first 3 stitches, 1 single crochet. And then every 4th. An increase. This is the last increase of round 5, and then we're going to start with round 6. Round 6 and 7 are really easy. Just make 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So you do that for 2 rounds, round 6 and 7. Just make 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now we're going to start with round 8. In round 8, we're going to single crochet in the first 4 stitches, and then we're going to make the increase in the 5th stitch. So in this first stitch, one single crochet. In the second stitch, one single crochet. In the third stitch, one single crochet. And then in the fourth stitch, one single crochet. And the fifth stitch, two single crochets in the same stitch. Now you have to repeat this until the end of the round. So in every first four stitches, one single crochet, and in every fifth, an increase. Now this is the last increase of round 8, and now we can start with round 9. Round 9, 10 and 11 are really easy. Just make one single crochet in every stitch of the round. So you do this for 3 rounds. Round 9, 10 and 11, just one single crochet in every stitch. In the next round, I'm going to show you how to crochet two single crochets together. First, we're going to make one single crochet in the first four stitches. So in this first stitch, one single crochet. In the second stitch, one single crochet. In the third stitch, one single crochet. Then in the fourth stitch, one single crochet. And then we're going to make a decrease. We're going to crochet the next two stitches together. To do this, you're going to go into the front loops of the next two stitches. So only the front loops. So this front loop, but also the next front loop. And then I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it through both front loops. And then I'll have two loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops. This is called an invisible decrease. I will also show you how to make a normal decrease, because it's easier when you're using plus yarn. When you make a normal decrease, you go into the next stitch, and not only the front loop, the whole stitch, and you grab the yarn and pull it through. You go to the second stitch, grab the yarn and pull it through. And now you have three loops in your crochet hook, and you pull the yarn through those three loops. Now that's how you make a normal decrease. And for plus yarn, this is much easier. And you won't see the decrease because, well, it's very fluffy yarn. Now we're going to continue with round 12. One single crochet in the first four stitches. And then we're going to make a decrease. We're going to crochet the next two stitches together. And we're going to repeat this until the end of the round. So in the first 4 stitches, 1 single crochet. And then crochet the 5th and the 6th stitch together. Now this is the last decrease of round 12, then we're going to start with round 13. In round 13, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and then we're going to crochet the 4th and the 5th stitch together. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet, in the second, 1 single crochet, in the third, 1 single crochet, and then we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together, go into the front loops of the next 2 stitches, grab the yarn and pull it through both loops. Grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops. Now we're going to repeat this until the end of the round. Now this is the last decrease of round 13. Now we're going to start with round 14. In round 14 we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches. And then we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. And then we're going to crochet the 3rd and the 4th stitch together. We're going to repeat this until the end of the round, so in every first 2 stitches, 1 single crochet, and then a decrease. Crochet the 3rd and the 4th stitch together. This is the last decrease of round 14. Then we're going to start with round 15. It's a really easy round, just 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. Before we continue making the next round, first I'm going to sew on the eyes. The eyes I'm going to be sewed over round 9 and 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So over these 2 rounds, I'm going to sew the eyes and add 7 stitches between both eyes. I will show you exactly how to sew on the eyes. You have to sew over the same spot several times to make a nice thick eye. So now that I think my eye looks great, I'm going to make a little knot on the inside. Now I'm going to sew on the second eye. 7 stitches from this eye. So this is the first, say 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So over here I'm going to sew on the other eye, the same way as we did with the first eye. Now, only have to make a little knot on the inside of the head. Now, we can continue to crochet the body. In the first 2 stitches of the next round, I'm going to make 1 single crochet. And in every 3rd stitch, I'm going to make an increase. So in the first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second, 1 single crochet. And now an increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. I'm going to repeat this until the end of the round. This is the last increase of round 16. The next 4 rounds are going to be really easy. There's 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So we do this for round 17, 18, 19 and 20. Just the 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now in the next round, round 21, we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first stitch and then we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. So we're going to crochet every 2nd and 3rd stitch together. So this is the first stitch and then we're going to make a decrease. And we're going to repeat this until the end of the round. So in the first stitch 1 single crochet and then crochet the next 2 stitches together. Stitch 2 and 3. Now this is the last decrease of round 21. And I'm going to put some stuffing in the body. In round 22, we're going to single crochet every 2 stitches together. So we're going to decrease 8 times. So every 1st and 2nd stitch, we're going to crochet together. Now this is the last decrease of around 22. And then I'm going to start with round 23. In round 23, I'm going to make one single crochet in the first two stitches, and then we're going to make a decrease. So in this first stitch, I'm going to make one single crochet, and in the second also one single crochet, and I'm going to make a decrease. I'm going to do this one more time. So in the first two stitches, one single crochet. And then you're going to make a decrease. Now the body is done. I'm going to cut the yarn and pull it through. And then we can still put in some stuffing. If you want to put in some more stuffing, then it's very difficult with your hands, so use a little tool. For example, a chopstick. I'm going to remove the marker yarn because we don't need the marker yarn anymore. And then we can close the hole. To do this, I'm going to go to every front loop of the last round that we made. Only the front loops. Then I'm going to pull the yarn to close the hole. And then I just have to hide the remaining yarn in the body. Now I'm going to make the snout. First start with a magic circle. So wrap the yarn around your finger twice. Pull the yarn to the loops, grab the yarn again and pull it through. Now I'm going to make 6 single crochets into the magic circle. As you can see, you can also crochet in the magic circle and keep it the magic circle on your finger if you find this easier. So now we've made 6 single crochets. And I'm going to close the magic circle, pull a small piece of yarn. One loop will become smaller, pull on the bottom side of that one to close the other one, and then close the magic circle completely. And you can start with round 2. In round 2 we're going to make an increase in every stitch of the round. On every stitch we're going to make an increase, so in the end we will have made 12 stitches. One more increase, and then we're going to start with round 3. In round 3, it's really easy, just one single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now I'm done with round 3. Then I'm going to fasten off with a slip stitch. Let me first remove the marker yarn. I don't need the marker yarn anymore. And then I'm going to make a slip stitch. To make a slip stitch, you go into the next stitch. Then grab the yarn. Pull it to that stitch, but also immediately to the loop on your crochet hook. And that's how you make a slip stitch. Now you can cut the yarn and pull it through. And then we're going to sew the snout on the body of the dog. Oh no, first we're going to, of course, sew on the nose. The nose will be sewed between round 1 and 2, and it's 2 stitches wide. Now the nose is done. I just have to make a little knot on the inside of the snout, and then we can sew the snout on the body. Now we're going to sew the snout between rounds 8 and 13 of the body. First I'm going to pin on the snout. The top of the snout is on the top of the eyes, and the bottom of the snout is 2 rows from the eyes. So first pin it in place, and then I will show you exactly how I sewed on the snout on the body. So now it's time to put a bit of stuffing in the snout before I continue to sew the snout on the body. Now you just have to hide the remaining yarn in the snout. Now we're going to make the ears. We're going to start making a magic circle. Wrap the yarn around your fingers twice. Go into the 2 loops with your crochet hook, grab the yarn, pull it through, grab the yarn again and pull it through the loop in your crochet hook. Now we're going to single crochet 6 times into the magic circle. So this is the 2nd single crochet, the 3rd single crochet, the 4th single crochet, the 5th and the 6th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and now we can close the magic circle. And now I'm going to start with round 2. In round 2, we're going to make an increase in every stitch of the round. First, let me get some marker yarn, some leftover yarn, to mark the beginning of my rounds. And then I'm going to make an increase in every stitch of the round. So 2 single crochets in every stitch. Now in this first stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. This is also called an increase. So we're going to increase 6 times. And then we'll have made 12 single crochets in the end of the round. Now I'm going to move the marker yarn and start on round 3. Round 3, 4 and 5 are really easy. You just have to do 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So you do this for 3 rounds. In the 6th round, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches and then we're going to make a decrease. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet, in the second, 1 single crochet. And then we're going to crochet the 3rd and the 4th stitch together. And then we're going to repeat this until the end of the round. Now, this is the last decrease of round 6. Round 7, 8 and 9 are really easy. Just 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So do this for round 7, 8 and 9. Just 1 single crochet in every stitch. In round 10, we're going to do 1 single crochet in every first stitch and then a decrease. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. And then crochet stitch 2 and 3 together. And you have to repeat this 2 more times until the end of the round. This is the last decrease of round 10. Then the ear is done. Just have to fasten over the slip stitch. And to do this, go to into the next stitch, grab the yarn, pull it to that stitch, but also immediately to the loop on your crochet hook. Then you can cut the yarn and pull it through. Now you have to make 1 more ear, because the dog has 2 ears. And then I will show you how to sew the ears on the body. We're going to sew the ears on round 6 of the body. So So this round 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So below this round, on round 6, we're going to sew round 10 of the ears. First I'm going to pin them on. And I will show you exactly how to sew these ears on the body. Now round 10 is sewed on. Because the eyes are sticking out a bit, I'm also going to sew the inside of the ear on the body. This is of course optional. I prefer to have the ears a bit closer to the head. So this is why I do this. Now, just have to hide the remaining yarn in the ear. Now, I'm going to sew the other ear on the body. Round 10 also on round 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so below round 5. I'll show you exactly again how to sew the ears on the body. Now you just have to hide the remaining yarn in the ear. Now the ears are done and we're going to make the legs. First start with the magic circle. So wrap the yarn around your finger twice, pull the yarn to the two loops, grab the yarn again and pull it through. Now I'm going to make 6 single crochets into the magic circle. This is the first single crochet. Then the second. The third single crochet. 4, 5, and one more, and then we can close the magic circle. We're going to do this by pull the small piece of yarn, one loop will become smaller, pull on the bottom side of that loop to close the other one, and pull on the small piece of yarn again. Now we can start with round 2. In round 2, we're going to increase 6 times. First I'm going to place a marker yarn and then I'm going to increase in every stitch of the round. So 2 single crochets in every stitch. The next one is really easy. Just one single crochet in every stitch of the round. And we do this for 1, 2 and 4. Just one single crochet in every stitch. In the next round, round 5, we're going to make one single crochet in the first two stitches, and then we're going to make 4 decreases. So in this first stitch, one single crochet, and in the second stitch, one single crochet, and then we're going to decrease 4 times. So crochet the next two stitches together. This is the first decrease. And also crochet the next two stitches together. This is the second decrease. Crochet the next two stitches together. The third decrease. Then one more time, a decrease. Crochet the next two stitches together. And that is the fourth decrease. And now I'm going to make one single crochet in the next stitch, and in the last stitch also one single crochet. Now let me move the marker yarn, and then I'm going to go make one single crochet in every stitch of the next round. Now I'm going to fasten over the slip stitch, cut the yarn and pull it through, now you have to make one more leg, because the dog has two legs. I'm gonna cut the magic ring yarn that's in the leg. Now you can also remove the marker yarn, you don't need it anymore. And then you just have to put a bit of stuffing in the legs. And now we're going to sew the legs on the body between round 17 and 21. This is on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. En dit is 17, so below the 17th round, I'm going to pin on the legs. And I will show you exactly how to sew on the legs on the body. First I'm going to sew on the last round that we made. So the top round of the legs. And then I'm also going to sew on the inside of the legs. Now I've sewed on the sixth round of the leg, and now I'm also going to sew on the inside of the leg to the body. Now I just have to hide the remaining yarn in the leg. Now I'll show you how to sew the other leg on the body between rounds 17 and 21. First round 6 of the leg to the body. Just have to hide the remaining yarn in the leg. Now the legs are done and we're going to make the arms. First start with the magic circle. So wrap the yarn around your finger twice, pull the yarn to the loops, grab the yarn again and pull it through. Now I'm going to make 6 single crochets into the magic circle. This is the first single crochet. Then the second. The third single crochet. 4. 5. And one more, and then we can close the magic circle. We're going to do this by pulling a small piece of yarn, one loop will become smaller, pull on the bottom side of that loop to close the other one, and pull on the small piece of yarn again. Now we can start with round 2. In round 2, we're going to do 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. We're going to do this for round 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Just 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now this is the last single crochet, and then I'm going to fasten off with a slip stitch. Then you can cut the yarn and pull it through. And you have to make one more arm. If you want, you can put some stuffing in the arm. The arm is so small that I don't think it's really necessary, but if you like to have a thicker arm, then put some stuffing in it. Now I'm going to sew the arms over round 16 of the body. So round 6 of the arms on round 16 of the body. I will show you exactly how to sew on the arms on the body. Now I just have to hide the remaining yarn inside the body or inside the arm. Now I'll show you how to sew on the other arm, on round 16. Now I just have to hide the remaining yarn. Now I'm going to make the tail for the dog. Now start with a magic circle. And this time we're going to single crochet 5 times into the magic circle. This is the first single crochet, then second single crochet, the third, 4, and 5. Now we can close the magic circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we start on the second round. Round 2, 3, 4, and 5 are the same. Just 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. If you find it difficult to make the tail because it's so small, it only has 5 stitches, then it's probably a good idea to make 6 stitches instead. But then you will probably have a thicker tail, but it will be easier to crochet. Now I'm going to fasten off with a slip stitch in the next stitch. I'm going to remove the marker yarn, don't need the marker yarn anymore. And then I'm going to fasten off with a slip stitch into the next stitch. So go into the next stitch, grab the yarn, pull it to the stitch and to the loop on your crochet hook. And you can cut the yarn and pull it through. And then the tail is done and we can sew it on the body, on the back of the body. We're going to sew it on round 19. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So over this round, we're going to sew the tail. Now, just have to hide the remaining yarn in the body or in the tail. Now we're going to make a chain with 12 chain stitches. First I'm going to make a little loop to start my chain stitch, my chain. And then I'm going to make 12 chain stitches. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it through the loop on the crochet hook. This is the first chain stitch. This is the second, third, is number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, one more, 12 chain stitches. Now we're going to join the last chain stitch to the first one with a slip stitch. So I'm going to go into this first chain stitch that we made. And I'm going to grab the yarn. And I'm going to join with a slip stitch. And I'm going to make 2 chain stitches. And now I'm going to make 1 half double crochet in every chain stitch. So first in the first chain stitch and then in every chain stitch we're going to make a half double crochet. have to do one more half double crochet, and then I'm going to make a slip stitch in the top of the first half double crochet that we made. So that's here, I'm going to make a slip stitch, and then you can cut the yarn and pull it through. Leave a long piece of yarn because we're going to wrap it around the bow to create the shape of the bow. Now that I've flattened it, then I can wrap the yarn around it very tightly, just a few times until you are happy with the shape of the bow. And I'm going to make a little knot on the back side. And then I'm going to sew the bow on the body of the dog. First, pin the bow on the body, and then I'll show you how to sew it on. There's a little bit of orange yarn sticking out. You can use your sewing needle to hide it. And now your cute amigurumi dog is done. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you liked it, please like the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. It would be really great if you could leave a comment on this video. If you like making amigurumi, check out all the videos on my YouTube channel. I also have lots of patterns on my website. And also bigger patterns in my Etsy shop. The bigger patterns, like this cute axolotl, take a bit more time to make. They're just as easy. Also this cute koala. But they take a bit more time because, they are bigger. And if you make them from bigger yarn, they'll become huge. Thank you so much for watching the video. And enjoy making many amigurumi.